I want to sing one of my songs before I give this testimony. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just the
30 seconds remaining for the songs.
When I think about the grace of God, when I think about all His works, when I count my blessing one by one, I go dance and scatter. Oh, dance and scatter. I go praise Him higher. Oh, praise Him higher. I go dance and scatter, praise Him higher. I go praise Him higher. Oh, oh. I just give you the brief of it. Hallelujah.
Amen. Let us put our hands together for Jesus Christ.
I want to thank God for His grace upon my life, for His kindness. To be sincere for you, since I came to Lagos, I've been facing challenges, facing battles, but the Lord has been there for me. Because I've tried 2 times to leave Lagos. But there's something that has been kept me. Before I came to Lagos, people did not allow me to come because I was...
Draw the mic closer to your mouth.
Because I was living a rough life that time. And people say, if I come to Lagos, say, ah, with this kind of life, where I live? Say, now nah, from there, I say, say, I can't go to another place. Say, make a note. So I seek advice from people. Some people give me their opinion. I have 2 in-laws then. I went to one and asked him. That one, he said, I should go to Lagos. Okay, no, the first one say I should not go to Lagos. About my business, that you help me. I said, okay, no problem. I went to the other one, he's a pastor, and he's a reverend now. I went to him when I discussed with him. He said I should come to Lagos. But still, I was not convinced. I was bothering myself. I began to pray to God. Later, I forgot. I said I will not come to Lagos again. So, on the day I went to work, I was coming back. I heard a voice. That was the first day I heard God speak. God told me in the bus, he said I should pack my thing and leave to Lagos. In that very night, I have a shop. What I say, I say bags. One of my bags that time is like 5,000 naira. Then I have only three pieces in my shop because things was very hard that time. I have to call one buyer. Then he said, my shop is the other side. I say, God, look at these goods. Come and give me the money. I will give you for 4,005. So I want to make use of the money. So the guy came and carried the market, 3 pieces. He gave me the money. That night, I entered 9th bus to Lagos. I did not even tell my sisters, nobody. When I get to Vega, I call them, say, are they Lagos? Will they shout, say, Lagos, come here. So, after everything, no challenge. When I want to leave, I remember all these things. I said, I cannot live like this because I did not come on my own. In my dream, God appeared to me. He showed me a rock. You know what he showed me? He said, anywhere his name has been written, he said it's like a rock that can never be moved forever. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That will give me confidence. I say the Lord is with me. I'm not on my own. But my testimony goes like this. Last week, things was very rough for me, very hard, but everything just broke. And I was asking God for favor. And God grants the favor for me. Hallelujah.
Let us put our hands together for Jesus Christ. That is the testimony from an item for Divine Favor program that just concluded.
And another thing that's funny, me, this one is, I call it crazy testimony. Because it's crazy to me. So we don't, they cut our light. So, is it on Tuesday, I'll be honest, they came back, they came and fixed the light. When they fixed the light was too hot. It was burning everything, burning my wall bracket. Then when I on television, the adapter was high, did not pick. Now I have to remove the adapter and plug the television on the right. When I plug the television, what I heard was smoke everywhere. I say, this one will not get money. Now I'm going to carry television up and down. I say, no problem. Man. If I saw it today, no wahala. So when I went out, I go and meet one of my guys that used to repair television. I told him what happened. He said, I should bring him. So that day, I came back in the night. When I woke up in the midnight, I was praying. Something said I should go and plug the television. So I was trying to do the thing ugly. I went back to my prayer. After praying finished, now I go plug the thing back. I had the thing bring light. I found everything all right. So I see, even till now, I'm surprised. Oh, I'm surprised because of the kind of smoke that that television brings. Nobody would believe that it can work. So I come say, I say, even God say I'm an engineer. He didn't repair television.
Don't study generator. And then somebody, I said, to confirm to you, when you press more, you say, let me go and plug this TV because I hear voice that the God of producer has repaired this TV. Let me go and plug it. You go and plug it because as small prayer you pray, the thing no show. For the first time.
He don't even gree.
Now you go back to your prayer and begin to pray. When you pray well, the spirit come again and tell you, go and plug that TV. I won't show you a miracle.
Yes.
Now you go and plug it. As you plug it this time, the television bring light. You carry your remote, you on it, the TV on. You begin to watch.
Tina!
Your friend will not help you again.
No, he
will help you. Now God will help you now. God will help you in every area of your life.
Amen.
So for this good thing the Lord has done for you, what advice? Because many of us here, they are still sitting down here, many never believe that this kind of miracles can happen. What advice do you have to give them concerning this ministry?
The advice I have to give to everyone here is that whatever you are asking of God, just believe that it will work. Because without faith, no man can please God. What God needs most is our faith. Put our trust. Because last week, when I was going through what I was going through, because my Bible used to bring message for me every morning. So in the morning, when he bring message, I opened the message. Then the Bible was telling me that whatever I ask of God, I should believe that he will do it for me. And that was the conclusion of everything. And as I believe God, things are
acts
of faith,
doing it for you. Let us jam our hands together to appreciate our Lord Jesus Christ. There is nothing God cannot do. May your testimony remain permanent to the glory of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.